for this great visitation today. Thank you for the light that you're shining upon our path so that we can see clearly and walk while it is still day. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Revelation last Thursday. Sorry, who wrote this? Praise the Lord. He said he saw a big man of God in Nigeria. He stood and was saying, I want to build a new church. Then he called for his people to come, and people were coming gradually. And suddenly, as I entered into the new church, they began to give everybody number. He said the rapture remains 1 second, and his sons were ignorant. Praise the Lord. You know, the book of Revelation says that he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the churches. So many new faces today, and so many of us also who have been very consistent. Particularly for those of us who have been very consistent. He that has an ear, let him hear. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Just before Kenneth Hagin passed away, how many of us believe that Kenneth Hagin was a prophet?
Oh, he was.
I don't see many hands up. If you are raising your hand, raise it well. Let me see.
He was.
Praise the Lord. There are men that are sent to specific generations for specific purposes. The commission of Martin Luther King was different. Martin Luther's commission was different. William Seymour's commission was different. Praise the Lord. Now, when you understand the moves of the Spirit, you would understand the mantles with which these men operated and the mantles that came upon them. Now, Kenneth Hagin came to lay a foundation for the church, a foundation for the church. And his foundation, the foundation that he laid, is a foundation many of us built our Christian lives upon. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He had many spiritual children all over the world. And if you look at the gospel today, many that received the spirit of his message are the only ones still teaching faith on the earth. Most ministers have diverted, they veered away. Most are teaching motivation. A lot are teaching deliverance and so many other gospels. Praise the Lord. But how many of us also believe that Kenneth Hagin's revelations and the truth he taught is not the end of the gospel? Praise the Lord. Because the gospel is dynamic. And for the whole of eternity, we'll be learning this God. He'll be unfolding every day. So there's no man that has the beginning and the end and the totality of everything. Praise the Lord. But some men are sent to do a certain work that is vital to the kingdom. Now, just before Kenneth Hagin died, Kenneth Hagin gave a prophecy. And he prophesied about a certain move of God that was going to start on the earth. And that this move was going to start with ministers and preachers who minister in the Spirit. Who minister in the Spirit. Praise the Lord. And that the Spirit of God was going to come and start a new move with them. Praise the Lord. Thank you, sir. And that the rest of the church world will continue in their program and their activities, and they would not know that the Spirit of the Lord has left and a new work has started. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I believe that man very strongly. The testimony of his life is a witness to that which he preached. Jesus Christ said something specifically, or the word of God says something specifically. He said, you know a prophet by his word. If what he prophesies comes to pass, he's a prophet. If it doesn't come to pass, he's not a prophet. Now, at the time this prophecy was given, three angels appeared to him. Was it two or three?
Three
angels. Now, those three angels came to herald change. Now, the first one, he looked like a man. That one had the body of a man and behaved like a man. Now, that angel came and he screamed, change, change, change. He spoke to America as a nation, Christians in America. And he told them that change was coming in the political arena. Now, that came to pass. He also, the second angel prophesied and said, change, change, change was coming. Change was coming in the financial and economic world of that nation. That many of the believers had been crying out to God because of their financial situation. He said change was coming. That angel also looked like a man. And he prophesied. Now the third angel that he saw. Now these two has happened as we speak. They all came to pass. There was change in the political arena. The government changed. And there was change at that time when that prophecy was given. America enjoyed economic prosperity. Now, the third angel, this angel did not have the body of a man. This angel has celestial body. His whole body was covered with feathers. And it was much bigger than the other two angels. And that angel began to prophesy about change, 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 change in the realm of the spirit. Change in the realm of the spirit. And he declared clearly that there was going to be coming a change in the realm of the spirit where he ministers to those who minister in the spirit where he ministers. Mm. God is tired of this party we are having. Mm. God is tired of these ceremonies that we are having. You know, God is tired of the lukewarmness. All over the church, there's idolatry everywhere. God is tired of it. Praise the Lord. And he prophesied that Michael was going to join forces with men on the earth to bring about this move of God to the church of the living God. I believe that those things have begun to happen. Hallelujah. Because all over the place, believers are asking questions. Believers are hungry. Believers are looking for God. And they are wondering, is this all there is to this Christianity? Praise the Lord. That is the purpose for this forum. That God started by himself. God started this place with two or three men who were coming together to pray and share the word. Praise the Lord. And the reason here is for us to see clearly from God's word what we ought to preach. As a minister of the gospel, what should I be preaching? What food should I be giving to my congregation? Many of us, we look at our spiritual children, and they don't look like human beings. I had a vision once, and I went into a church, and in that church, I saw a creature, and that creature was a crossbreed of a goat and a human being. He had the face of a man, but the features of a goat were on that face. When you look at the face, you know that this is a crossbreed between a goat and a man. And then even though he had the body of a man, but the body was on all fours, running and crawling like a goat. And the wisdom I had of that revelation was that that is the product of that ministry. The children of that ministry, that is what they look like in the realm of the spirit. Because there has been a crossbreed, an injection of satanic sperm into the life of God's children. We have few, because goats represents Satan. So Satan has injected something into the church. And now when you look at us in the spirit, you don't know whether we're God's children or we're children of Satan. And the instruction is very clear in Revelation chapter 17 and 18. Come out of her, my people. Come out of her. Come out of Babylon. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you're coming for the first time today, please get all the messages we've been teaching. We've been sharing here, not teaching. We just share with one another. We're all ministers of the gospel. We honor every minister here. And we share with one another. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So get all that we have been sharing on faith, so you don't go away lopsided. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We've been sharing on faith for the past 3 or 4 weeks now. And the different dimensions of faith. The natural faith. Faith that the ordinary man on the street has. The beginner faith. The time I gave my life to Christ. The faith as my lifestyle as a Christian, because the just shall live by faith, and the end of my faith, which is the salvation of my soul. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. For the benefit of everyone, I want to just read from the book of Matthew, chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6. The word of God. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 1 that the power of salvation is in the gospel.
Yes.
That means the power that saved my spirit is in the gospel. The power that will save my soul is in the gospel. And the power that will save my body is in the gospel. Praise the Lord. That's why Jesus said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. Our responsibility is to believe. Say with me, believe.
Believe.
Say with me, believe.
Believe.
Say with me, believe.
Believe.
Today, Pastor Ayo taught us how to believe. Some of the things we need to do to help us believe. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Spending time praying in the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. When we spend time and fellowship with the Holy Ghost, when you open the Word of God and you read it, you believe it easily. I know what I'm saying. When you spend time in the Spirit and you open God's Word, when you read it, you will believe it easily. So something happens to us when we pray in the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Lay not up, Matthew 6:19. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon the earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I dare to say that the reason why many cannot come for, you know, sometimes we tell people, we say we have Monday morning meeting. They say, eh?
Monday
morning? Is your husband a businessman? I say yes. What about you? I say yes. And you say every Monday morning, I'm sorry, I cannot do Monday morning meeting.
Okay.
That is priority in my business. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The light of the body is the eye. If therefore your eye be single, your whole body shall be full of light. But if your eye be evil, your whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore your eye be single, if your eye is looking at only one thing, if my eye is single, my whole body will be full of light. So if I have one focus, if I'm looking at just one thing, my whole body will be flooded with light. Praise the Lord. He said, but he didn't now say, if your eye be double. He said, if your eye be evil. So it means that once I do not have sin, single focus, the only other thing, option left, is evil eye.
That's right.
This is very deadly, isn't it? You hold one, this world on this hand, money on this hand, you hold God on this hand. You know what to do with each one. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If therefore the light that is indeed the darkness, if therefore, now this is Jesus talking, this is not Paul or Peter, this is Jesus talking. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness? If you as a believer, because you are the light of the world, and then that your light that is in you is darkness. The light which you are using to see is darkness. It says, how great is that darkness? No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other. I am telling you the truth. I am telling you the truth. You can never serve two masters at the same time. You can never serve this world and serve God at the same time. You can never serve your business and serve God at the same time. You can never serve your ministry and serve God at the same time. You can never serve your congregation and serve God at the same time. You can only serve one. Only one. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. I'm just reading, because if we were to teach, you will teach this in 4 weeks. This is Matthew chapter 6. You teach it in 4 weeks. Every Monday we come, we teach it, teach it, teach it. We'll continue again. But I'm just reading, trusting the Lord that our spirits have been opened. And as the word of God is being read, it will wash us.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Matthew 6 verse 25. It said, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life. As Pastor Ayo ministered, and Pastor Dave, Pastor Samson, sorry. Maybe Pastor Ayo, you should speak next week. As Pastor Samson ministered and Pastor Dave ministered, I heard the thoughts of many hearts. What about what to eat? Those were the thoughts of many hearts. There were many questions, and there were many offenses also. Praise the Lord. Now Jesus said, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what you shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold the fowls of the air, they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much better than they? Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto your stature? Let me ask a question. How many of you have had your house rent due, and there was no money to pay it? How many of you have brought money to pay it by thinking about not having the money to pay the rent? Eh?
No.
How many of you have been in debt, and while in that situation, there was no hope in sight to get out of that debt? And how many of you came out of that debt by worrying over that debt? How many of you have had need for your children's school fees and you couldn't pay? And the thoughts of those children not paying their fees brought money. How many? All these situations I've mentioned, I've been in all of them. Myself and my husband, I've been in debt. I've owed house rents. have owned school fees. In fact, I have withdrawn my children from school one time, kept them at home for one time, bought Blackboard and taught them because we couldn't pay school fees. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 The women, are you here? We're going to teach ourselves how to build our homes and build our husbands. Do you know your husband's life is in your hands? It's in your tongue? It's on your knees? It's in your bowels? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. 27th of December. Immediately after church, pastor's wives, immediately after service, don't go home, just come. You eat lunch. When you get here, immediately you come, you eat lunch. Then we'll start. Praise the Lord. Your husband is welcome. You don't want to see your face.
What about we that we did?
My husband.
No matter when I was
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much better than they? Which of you by taking thought can add one cubit unto your stature? And why take thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? Therefore, take no thought, saying, therefore, take no thought, saying. Therefore, take no thought, saying. Therefore, take no thought, saying. This is our battle. Can I believe this instruction? This is an instruction. Do we see that it's an instruction?
Yes.
It's an instruction.
Yes.
So when we do contrary to this instruction, we go contrary to faith.
Yes.
You see, when we do contrary to this instruction, we do what? Contrary to faith. I know that Pastor Samson said, for my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. He's talking about spiritual need. But I believe that all my needs are there. My natural needs are there. Everything I need, because the gospel provides for everything that you need in life. What God wants to remove from us is covetousness. What God wants to remove from us is worldliness. What God wants to remove from us is pride of this life. What God wants to remove from us is haughtiness. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So when you take no thought what you shall eat or what you shall wear, your confidence is in the God that shall supply all your needs. You are obeying him. You will take the word of God. You say, Father, see your word. You say, I should take no thought. I refuse to take thought. I refuse to take thought. Verse 32, for after all these things do the Gentiles seek. Now, I need to see that God hates this drive. Seeking for what to eat. That is what the Gentiles are using the life and the faith he put in them. That's what they are using it for. So he says, I don't like it. Your faith is to seek me.
What I love.
Your faith is to seek my pleasure.
My pleasure.
Your faith is to seek my will. Many of us have children. Some of us didn't achieve so much. So the things we couldn't achieve, we want our children to achieve it. We drive them hard, educationally and all that. But we never drive them in the course of the gospel. Now you can be making noise and we say, you children, you don't go to church. But what is in your heart? What are you desiring for them in your heart? How much time have you taken to wail before God concerning their spiritual life? No, but you spend time praying about your needs. I'm praying about, you know, the next big house and the next big car and this one and that one. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For after all these things, will the Gentiles see? For your heavenly Father knows that you have need of these things. He says, but you. Who gave that promise? Sister Destiny. I like that you. Praise the Lord. He said, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Brothers and sisters, the kingdom of God is not ministry.
That's right.
Pastors, are you angry with me?
No.
Right on. No.
Evangelists, are you angry with me? The kingdom of God is not that I am not a pastor of a parish.
No.
You have not found the kingdom.
That's right.
The kingdom of God is not that you are now the bishop of a huge church. That is not the kingdom of God. Jesus said it's not by observation. Jesus said you don't see it with the natural eyes. Jesus said the kingdom is within you. Within you. Hallelujah. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We have carried all these things shall be added unto you ahead of seeking. We swapped the scriptures. So we still end up seeking all these things and rejecting the kingdom. We reject the pleasures of the kingdom. We reject the life of the kingdom. We reject the joy of the kingdom. We reject the purity of the kingdom. We reject the righteousness of the kingdom. Praise the Lord. But this is God's oath. God's oath to us. God's what? Oath. His word. He has exalted his word above his name. Above all his name. Not just his name. All his name. This is his oath to his people. Seek me. Seek me with all your heart. Seek me with all your heart. Make me your pleasure. Make me your desire. Make me your hunger. And I shall supply all your needs. All those things that the Gentiles are seeking. They will be busy seeking it. But something will be bringing them for you. That's how it works. That's how it works. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, it will not work for you. Faith will not work for you when you try it. Hello? Faith will not work for you when you try it. Let me try this thing and see whether it works. It will not work. It will fail. It's not for trial.
Believe it.
You have not because you ask not. Isn't that what James said? He said, because you doubt, you don't have. You ask amiss. To consume it on your lust. Now, when you hear this truth, your mind, your heart will not say, let me go and try what they said. The word of God is not for trying. The word of God is for believing. Say with me, believing. Say believing. Say believing. Say
believing.
The things that have derailed us, men of God, is these things. These things. It makes us preach a gospel the way we should not preach it. So that those who came with their money bags will not go home with their offering. Let them go. They are not fit for the kingdom. Let them go. Let them take their money and go. God will provide your needs. Teach the truth. So that you can escape the damnation of hell. No, because this thing is serious. Jesus told the Pharisees. He said, you don't enter the kingdom. You don't allow other people to enter. He said, how shall you escape the damnation of hell?
How?
How?
Christ.
Now, Pharisees were not committing adultery.
Yes.
They don't commit adultery.
No.
They don't commit fornication. No. They tell the truth. Oh. They don't work on the Sabbath. Oh.
They fast.
They obey
God. They fast with long faces. They pray.
They
pay tithes. They come to Cori.
Time. Oh, that could mean they obey God.
Those are spices. They pay tithes on those things. The Bible says they have forgotten the weightier matters of the law. Judgments. Judgment is not God will kill you. Judgment is the righteous standard of God. The judgments of God. How God sees. How God thinks. How God, what God wants. What is acceptable to God. You have forgotten it. You have forgotten mercy.
Judgment.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can we begin to pray in the Spirit?